Santaya. Likanda bajiko tobori kalarabo shatalaraya. Mazinta baligorobo shataya. Speaking to your life, speaking to your marriage, speaking to the life of your children. God is like a seed. When you speak, it plants, it grows. You know, if you are a woman and you are having problem with your marriage, instead of you calling your husband demons, calling your wife demons, why not speaking to the life? If someone have let you down in the past, someone has bring shame to your life, someone has said you will not succeed, you don't need to go and fight the person in the physical. Prayer, tell God to change it. Tell God to prove to them that he is God in your life. Tell God to prove to that enemy that he is God in your life. So you need God in your life to make a difference. And for you to be able to be a prayerful person, you need a permanent relationship with God. How do we have this permanent relationship with God? By accepting Jesus as our Lord and personal Savior, by making him our friend. Not only when we are in problem, we have to run to him. Not only when we are in challenges, we need to know that God is God. No, we need Jesus at every time of our life, whether in challenging, whether in good time, in every time of our life, we need Jesus. We need him in our life, in our destiny, for us to succeed in this generation that we are. This generation that is full of wickedness, where husband can betray the wife, where wife can betray the husband, where relation can poison you. Let me tell you something. At times, a lot of people that you feel that your friend that have not manifested in the physical are even your enemies. The ones you call your enemies might not be your enemies. The people you have misunderstanding with, the people you just know that there is trouble in between them, might not be your enemies. Your enemies might be that close friend. Your enemies might be that very close family that is so stick to you. You will know that is your enemy. And that is why you need to pray. Your enemy could be that person that you are even feeding. That person that you share your clothes with could be your enemy. Your enemy might not be the person that you are thinking is your enemy. That is why you have to be prayerful. That is why you have to allow God to take charge over your home. That is why you have to allow God to take charge over your marriage. You have to allow God to take charge over your business. Sometimes you think, oh, the person that is my enemy is a person selling the same stuff with me that is so close to me. That's my enemy. He's jealous because I'm selling well. That person might not be your enemy. Your enemy might be the boy in your shop. It might be your sales guy in your shop. Sometimes the enemies don't come like an enemy. They come like a friend. They are so stick to you. They are informants. They monitor you. They monitor your destiny. They monitor your movement. They monitor your profit. They monitor your joy and they want to sour it with pain. And how do you overcome these people? By prayer and be close with Jesus. God cannot fail. And you know he cannot fail in our time. He's an ancient of days but relevant in our generation. He can never fail in our time. He's the same God of today, tomorrow, and forever. He cannot fail in our time. He cannot be a liar. He cannot fail. His word is permanent. His word is yea and amen. He cannot fail. He cannot turn his word. So you need Jesus for you to be able to succeed in life. You need Jesus for you to be able to break through in life. You need Jesus for you to be able to make difference. Okay? So we need Jesus. Don't be afraid. If you have God, you are an overcomer. If you have Jesus, you are an overcomer. It does not matter how the enemy have treated you. It does not matter what is threatening your life. It does not matter what is threatening your health. It does not matter what they are doing in their secret places. He is the head of principalities and powers. Nothing takes him unaware. He is the one that watch over us. He doesn't sleep. He does not faint. He does not get weak. He does not go old. That is the best friend that we can stick to. We can relate our problem to. He understands our pain. All he needs you to do is for you to tell him what you are going through. This is Great Goodness, people. AG Executive Kitchen, where we cook and talk relationship. This morning, we are not cooking. We are talking about prayer and your relationship with God. You need Jesus to succeed. In case you're watching me, you have not subscribed to our page, Facebook page, our Instagram, Telegram, Great Goodness People, AG Executive Kitchen, what are you waiting for? Do. Please share this message. Let people know. Instead of them to be carrying the burden, instead of them to be in pain, instead of them to be in sorrow or be depressed or run to the wrong people, let them put their trust in God. And the only way we can pray and the only way we can have a good prayer life is when we have relationship with Jesus. So if you're watching me, you have not given your life to Jesus, what are you waiting for? Jesus is calling you. He said, come unto me, I will give you rest. I will give you peace. They all belong to him. Jesus is calling you. Give your life to Jesus. Make him your friend, and your life will never remain the same. Praise the Lord. So see you next time. And I'm going to let you know our next program. I was saying the other day, I'm going to have a round table with some special people. We're going to talk about forgiveness in a relationship, in a marriage. How do you forge ahead when your husband or your wife has offended you and you still want to keep that marriage? How do you do it for you not able to remember the past or to forge ahead for peace to reign in your marriage? So I'm not going to discuss this thing alone. I'm going to invite some people. So I will let you know the date very soon. We are preparing. But before then, see you. I love you guys. God bless you. And if you are watching me, you are facing any challenge and you're saying I'll be praying, it doesn't look as if God is not answering me, I want to tell you that I decree by the authority in the blood of Jesus that solution is here right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I come against every foundational power and every powers in your father's house that is fighting your life and destiny. I command them to be destroyed by the power in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. You are blessed. See you next time. Love you all. Bye-bye.